One of the ways to make it easier to work in Excel is to know the handy shortcuts for moving in a worksheet. Hi, I'm Don Bjork, the software pro. I'm also a Microsoft certified trainer and certified Excel expert. Let's look at easy navigation shortcuts for Excel. The first is Control and the End key. This will move you to the bottom right-hand corner of your worksheet, whether it's 100 rows or 10,000 rows. If this moves beyond the last point of data in your worksheet, then you may want to delete some of the extra rows and columns that are left over from previous work. Control Home. This will take you to the upper left-hand corner of your worksheet, often to cell A1. If you have Freeze Panes enabled, this will take you to the first available active cell. Next, let's look at how we can move around our current data range. So for instance, to move to the bottom of this column, that would be Control and the down arrow key. It would only stop if there was a blank cell somewhere in between. Control up. Control right moves you to the far right-hand side of this data range. And Control left. That will move you to the very beginning of the row. Another way to get to the beginning of the row is to hit the home key. To be more specific with your navigation, use Go To. This is available in three different ways. The name box, which is just to the left of your formula bar, is a great place to either navigate to an existing range name or to a cell address. For instance, G50. And now Excel moves to that specific location. To bring up the Go To dialog box, that's either the F5 function key or Control G. From here, you can specify the location you want to move to. You would also see any range names listed here. And once again, let's say we want to go to H75. And simply OK or Enter will take us to that location. Let's look at that again, either F5 or Control G. Now choose Special. This is an excellent way to highlight specific parts of an Excel spreadsheet, whether they're blank cells, conditional formats, places where you have data validation. For this, I'll choose Formulas. When you have very detailed, complex data, this is a great option for auditing to make sure, for instance, that you have formulas in all the places where you expect it versus some raw data entry. Let's see what happens for this. And although this is a simple example, again, with a complex worksheet, this will highlight where there are formulas. Your next step might be to format these cells to make it easier to audit and confirm that formulas are every place that they should be within your worksheet. You'll also find many of these handy navigation tools on the Home tab of the ribbon under Find and Select. Here you'll see Go To, Go To Special, and a number of the most commonly used Go To Special actions, such as formulas. Now you've seen multiple ways to save time and effort navigating in an Excel spreadsheet. For more tips and shortcuts on being productive with Excel, head to thesoftwarepro.com/Excel. This is also where you'll find a handout of keyboard shortcuts for navigating in Excel. If this training was helpful, please like and comment on this video and subscribe to this channel. This is Don Bjork, the Software Pro. Thanks for watching.